One of the most critical precursors to the pursuit of cryopreservation of semen is to have a successful artificial insemination technique. And the honeybee system is fortunate to have a long-standing and highly successful insemination technique. A couple other videos in the series cover topics such as selection methods for honeybee breeding and instrumental insemination techniques. Cryopreservation is a technique used for the preservation of biological materials at extremely low temperatures, typically in liquid nitrogen, at around minus 196 degrees Celsius. The major breakthrough that is often credited as the beginning in cryopreservation of semen was the discovery of use of glycerol as a cryoprotectant. This was published in the journal Nature in 1949. The goal of a successful cryopreservation protocol is the prevention of intracellular ice formation and the ability to retrieve viable cells. The basic approach is to reduce the amount of water inside the cells or to change the composition of the cytoplasm without causing osmotic or toxic issues. Implementation and use of cryopreservation in honeybees has two general uses or goals. One is the conservation of honeybee subspecies or breeding lines, and two is for commercial purposes like breeding advancement. The honeybee system is one of those species in which cryopreservation of semen has been underutilized. It is at a bit of a disadvantage compared to other important agricultural species in a couple of ways. One, it is the very small volumes of semen produced. This makes many aspects of cryopreservation research and implementation difficult. And the other is that in honeybees, we need a queen to store the semen for weeks and produce hundreds or even thousands of fertilized eggs. People should manage expectations for the use of preserved semen, because while it can be used as a valuable tool, it should not be expected to be utilized in the same way that fresh semen can be. In this video, we will be demonstrating one method of cryopreservation that was largely developed by John Harbo in the 70s and 80s at the USDA Bee Research Station in Baton Rouge. We use a controlled freezing rate utilizing DMSO as a cryoprotectant in a buffer containing egg yolk. There is great interest in finding replacements for or ceasing the use of egg yolk because it is a biologic material with its own set of highly variable components. But for now, we are still utilizing it as a component in our cryopreservation protocol. We utilize 0.25 cc or 250 microliter cryostraws, which are cut to a length of about 6 centimeters. We generally freeze in 20 microliter volumes, but this can be adjusted depending on the purpose of the cryopreservation program. Our cryopreservation solution is composed of three components: 50% Harbo's buffer, 25% egg yolk, and 25% DMSO. The cryopreservation solution is then mixed with fresh semen in a ratio of 3 parts semen to 2 parts cryosolution. The solution is slowly added to the semen while gently mixing. The combined semen and cryo diluent is then loaded into the cryostraws. Starting with a small amount of diluent or saline, then an airspace. The semen mixture is added next. Then another airspace. Another small amount of saline or diluent is added, and then finally a small airspace is added at the end of the straw. The airspace at the end of the straw allows space for the straw to be properly sealed. A proper seal is important to prevent liquid nitrogen from entering the straw, as this can cause the sample to burst out during the thawing, and liquid nitrogen entering the straw can create a biological contamination issue. The straws are then sealed and labeled. The straws are then floated in a room temperature water bath, which is then placed in a 4 degrees Celsius refrigerator to allow the semen to cool slowly. While the straws are cooling, the programmable freezing unit can be set up. Once the water bath has reached 4 degrees Celsius, the straws are then transferred to the freezing unit. It is important that the straws be transferred from the water bath to the freezing unit quickly to prevent changes in temperature. But they also must be dry so they do not freeze to the walls of the freezing unit itself. Once all the straws are loaded, the freezing program is started. We freeze at a rate of 3 degrees per minute from 4 degrees Celsius to negative 40 Celsius. While the straws are freezing, we prepare a liquid nitrogen bath and prep goblets for storing the straws. Once the straws reach negative 40, they are rapidly transferred to the liquid nitrogen bath and packaged into the cryovials. It is important that once they are in the liquid nitrogen, that they not be removed until thawing to prevent changes in temperature. Cotton is used to secure the straws in the cryovials to prevent them from floating out during transfer and storage. When it is time to utilize the sample, straws are thawed in a 40 degrees Celsius water bath for about 10 seconds. The plug and sealed ends are cut off, and the straw is then inserted into the insemination system. The cryopreservation process causes damage to the cells, and while sperm motility is often excellent or indistinguishable from fresh semen, fluorescent staining and instrumental insemination demonstrate that cryopreservation damages cells and has major impacts on fertilization capacity. Queens inseminated with cryopreserved semen can produce fertilized offspring that are capable of becoming queens. However, large numbers of unfertilized eggs are laid, and some queens lay only unfertilized eggs. To increase the probability of producing offspring, it is important to inseminate many queens and graft a lot of larvae in order to get a few good queens. At this point, it is not the purpose to produce fully productive queens with cryopreserved semen. The purpose is to recover genetic material from the preserved semen. Only a few fertilized eggs used to produce queens accomplishes this goal. The preservation of female gametes or preservation of embryos would also be a powerful tool, and progress in this area is being made. For now, we have to rely on the cryopreservation of honeybee semen, and while limiting, can still be used to preserve valuable genetic diversity.